Before the creation of British Rail in 1948, Britain was made up of four major companies. They were the London and North Eastern Railway, the London, Midland and Scottish Railway, and of course the Great Western Railway, where I come from. My name is Oliver and I am a GWR 14XX tank engine. I was built in 1934 and was one of many 14XX tank engines.
Morning, Oliver!
Good morning, Clarence. And you too, Paul.
Top of the morning.
There were 76 of us built. I remember the names of all my brothers and sisters, but we'd be here all day if I named them all. The two who were the closest were called Clarence and Paul. We lived at a small station on the lower southeast of England. There was also William, a class 67 XX who would often visit. And it was a very pleasant life. Well, mostly pleasant. In 1949 we were all repainted into that boring British Rail livery. We hated it at first, but eventually we got used to it.
Tom, how you met me, Mr. Oliver?
Oh yes, of course.
Hello, Mr. Clarence. Or is it Mr. Paul?
I'm neither. I'm Oliver.
Oh, goodness me. How many of you tank engines are there?
I've been pulled by Bob, Jerry, Tim, George, Chris, and they all look exactly the same.
But anyways, nice to meet you, Mr. Oliver.
Nice to meet you, what's your name?
Name? Oh, we Rolling Stock are too low ranks for a name.
Rubbish, everyone deserves one. Unless, of course, you're a troublesome truck like those. The trucks were troublesome like usual, but Toad did such a good job of keeping them in order, and I was very impressed. He may be timid, but Toad stands no nonsense, and I have the utmost respect for him. My goodness, how did you manage to get all those trucks to behave? You're one of the most useful brake vans I know.
Why, thank you, Mr. Oliver.
I think you deserve a name.
Well, if you say so, I'd be honored. But I can't think of any names.
How about Toad? You are a Toad brake van, so it fits you perfectly.
I like the sound of that. Toad and Shabby.
Of course, Toad didn't realise what an actual Toad was for many years, but we soon became quite good workers together. The other brake vans were often lazy, but Toad was so hard-working that the engines would often fight over who would get to take him out.
Well, he's made headlines many times now, especially when he took the governor of Sodor. And what about your coach Isabel?
Before I escaped, Isabel was just an ordinary coach among the crowd. There were lots of auto coaches on our line. I remember some of the names were Shirley, Connie, Tabitha, Mary, the list goes on. The coaches were special because they had controls that were wired up to the engines. Therefore, the driver could drive the engine from the coaches. The Great Western was very into making rail traffic efficient. They also had slip coaches, which could be uncoupled while the train was still moving, and the guard would brake the coach to the station platform. We have some on our line now.
Must have been very productive.
Indeed it was, until the invasion of the diesels. They started to come into style in the mid-1950s. At first they were just the Class 08 shunters, which were much easier to use for arranging coaches and trucks. Then in the late 50s, the mainline diesel started taking over. I remember one diesel in particular, who was very horrid. He arrived in 1961 and his name was Darby, likely off to where he was built.
To hell with steam. There's something called efficiency. It rises through time, through change.
To hell with us. You can go to hell, you dirty brute! How about I meet you there?
Don't listen to him, Clarence. I believe his mouth is where his exhaust comes out.
There's not a steam engine in sight apart from us. 10 years ago, this whole area would be flocking with them.
You are right, Oliver. Still, I'm sure we'll always have you, sir.
As much as I wanted to believe that, I knew it wouldn't be true. The 60s saw an exponential drop in steam engines. Soon, on average, we only had 2 trains a day, and were just sitting in the yard most of the time. 1964 was, well, the beginning of the end. They withdrew the auto coaches from service on our line and replaced them with big BRMK1s. They were quite nice and comfortable, but it just wasn't the same. Then they retired Clarence and sent him away. The same happened to Paul in 1965. It was just me and William left. Then we came to 1967, which was the final year.
Guess what, Oliver? I'm going to be preserved! I've been bought!
Oh, that's fantastic! I wish I could be preserved.
I'm sure you will. You're the last 14XX in these parts. Wouldn't want to get rid of that.
I'll also be the last steam engine. Guess that will suck.
Oh yes, that's right.
Oh, I wish there was a railway somewhere that steam engines could be guaranteed a home at. There needs to be a sanctuary for steam locomotives.
I've heard of something kind of like that. You know the island of Sodor, right?
Yes, of course.
The controller there is dedicated to preserving steam. There are a few diesels, but the majority of that railway is still under steam power, and it's likely not going to change. Back in 55, I was talking with an engine at Paddington who was about to go there.
Oh really? Do you remember his name?
Well, his real name was Montague, but he went by a nickname. I think it was Duck or Goose.
Oh, that would be the perfect place for an engine like me. However, since I'll likely be the last engine here, I may just be preserved. But I wasn't preserved. In fact, I wasn't even the last engine. About 5 days later, the yard manager came to speak to me. Withdrawn? When and why?
I'm sorry, Oliver. It's manager's orders. You'll be put into storage next week. We just can't afford to operate steam anymore.
And I'll be scrapped, right?
Well, considering that's usually what happens, I'm so sorry, Oliver. The manager just doesn't seem to give a damn. He claims we're falling behind in the railway business.
And thus it was arranged. I remember my last run. The train was very crowded. The people were sad to see me go. But at the same time, they were glad steam was finally being eradicated. My driver and fireman were sad too. They were only qualified to drive steam engines, so finding work would be extremely difficult. Whilst putting the coaches back in their shed, I saw Toad and Isabel looking shabby in a siding.
You're being scrapped, aren't you?
Yes, and I can only guess you two are as well. Oh, how dreadful. But I guess everything must come to a close eventually. And I think we have finally reached that Great Western end. I puffed into the old shed one last time. It was empty, ready to be demolished. The breeze blew gently through the berths where my brothers had been, knowing I would soon join them. It was over.
Oliver! 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 Wake up!
Huh? What's going on?
Come on, boy. We're getting you out of here. We're leaving.
Leaving? Where on earth are we going?
The island of Sodor. Our only hope. It's worth the shot. Now come on.
The driver and fireman quickly but quietly set up my fire. My wheels were wobbling with excitement. I had a chance of surviving. My driver was about to pull the regulator when a thought struck me. A driver? I think there are two who would like to tag along.
Oh,
Oliver?
What are you doing, Mr. Oliver?
Rescuing you, of course. We're going to Sodor. How long will it take to get there?
It's about a 300-mile journey. If we don't want to be spotted, we'll have to go at night. The trains end at 1 and start up again around 5:30. We'll find a place to hide during the day, then continue at night.
We're escaping! We're escaping!
Shh! We don't want to be caught. Now, we've got enough steam. I guess we're all ready.
Guess so, driver.
Right. Let's get the hell out of here. Station not too far from here. We'll stop and hide there.
To know that there's reports of a mystery train running down the line. I hope they don't mean us. There's an old disused quarry branch up the line. That would probably be your best bet if you don't want to be spotted.
Shh! Hold on. I think I smell steam engine.
We charged on ahead and hoped that the coal would last. But unfortunately, that just wasn't the case.
Well, well. Look what we have found here. I'll try to contact the controller and see what he wants to do with these, disposable railway stuff.
Be realistic, Toad. The chances of us getting out of here are a billion to one.
Still a chance.
What the? I've not heard a sound like that since... Oh, Glory! Wake up! Wake up, everyone!